This is Mr. Evilcheese, and this is my review of the bloody black and white two-pack of the comic versions of Rick Grimes and Michonne. And holy shit, there's a lot of accessories in there. Look at all those guns, man. All those knives and little tools and all kinds of things in there. That's a lot of crap for a pack of toys, man. And there's some other things. I never got these two zombies, but man, I used to think they looked pretty shitty, but looking at them here, they look pretty cool. Especially even how they can do that kind of ripping them apart stuff and then explodey head stuff. I should get them someday. I don't have this colored version of Rick. Never got that one. I have that Michonne though. But seriously, look at all the freaking guns in there. He's got like a whole bunch of shotguns, and then over there he's like, look at that. That looks like it's Michonne's gun, but that's not. That's Rick's gun. He's like, nope, 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 nope. That's my gun. I just don't got enough room over here, so I stuck it over there next to you. But you cannot have it because that's my gun. You don't use guns anyway. Okay, well, I'm gonna open this up now. Oh, while I was opening this up, I didn't even notice this art in the back. It's pretty cool. It's got like zombies and crap, and they're attacking this giant piece of cheese. But no, that's not evil cheese. Unless they're massaging it. If they're massaging it, then that is probably evil cheese. But holy shit, look at that. Doesn't that look awesome? Man, they look like they're gonna do something really badass. Oh, I don't know. Maybe bust ass. Something involving ass. I don't know what the hell they're gonna do. But they look pretty cool. That's all I'm gonna say. And, I'm gonna say some more, actually. But I like the black and white versions. I don't know, before, every time I seen the black and white versions, I was like, nah, and then I got a couple of them, like, that's pretty cool, man. I really like them. And, it's pretty much how the comic looks, except that the comics don't have the red blood. Everything's black and white in the comics, except for the cover. But I like the blood splattered on them. I wish the comics did that too. But I keep saying but. Butt and asses. I don't know what the hell is going on tonight, but I said it again. I guess I'll go over Rick first, since I never had the colored version of Rick. No, I think he comes with all the same accessories. I know he comes with his backpack or duffel bag full of guns, and I'm assuming he probably came with his hatchet and handgun, just like the color version, because I had the Michonne and she comes with all the same stuff. But I like this little bag. It has a little peg on it, and it goes into a hole on his shoulder, if you can see that there, to help keep it on. And you can stick these shotguns in it. It comes with four shotguns. Look at that shit. Four, like, regular-looking shotguns. Well, I guess this one's like a rifle or something. Maybe. I think it's a shotgun. I don't know. I'm not a gun expert. They all look like shotguns to me. And this one's like a sawed-off shotgun or something. But they all got like a little bit of blood splatter on them in various places. That's cool. Four shotguns, and they all fit in there nicely. Although you should put the sawed off one in last, because if you don't, then it doesn't stick out very much. It sinks down in. And he also comes with a hatchet, which Rick uses a hatchet in the comics a lot. Don't really use it in the show too much. He mostly just uses his revolver in the show. But comic version has the hatchet. And then he's got his handgun. And this is Rick's cop uniform, which he uses early on in the comic series. And he eventually comes back to it for a little while, but mostly just in the beginning. And he has his jacket on. I like that. The blood splatter is pretty cool on him. It's like all the way up on his face. Like he must have really been ripping through some zombies or something. Splattered all over the damn place. All over his little cop symbol. None of his back, though. But I guess you don't kill people. Unless he's like, run up to zombies and like, pew, 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 and then chopping them. That's why there's no blood on his back. But the hat is not removable. It's stuck on his head, and that's fine. I don't mind that. They're coming out with that new version of Rick, and new comic version of Rick, and he doesn't have the hat, so that's cool. And look, you notice his hand's bandaged. He's always fucking up his hand, man. His hand's always getting screwed up. He's getting it broken, and then he's getting it chopped off. And in the show, he got it all screwed up, too. I mean, he needs to take care of his hands a little better. I'm assuming this handgun will fit into here, like most of the Walking Dead figures can do. And it works amazing. And The hatchet, I guess he can just kind of stick that right there. That's where he keeps that, don't you know? This is how real men stand. Here's a comparison of the TV show version of Rick in his cop suit. And I took the head off of the Series 2 Rick and stuck it on at Series 1 Rick so that he has the full cop uniform. He doesn't have his jacket, though, like this one does. But still, it's pretty much the same thing. You see, he's got his revolver instead of that handgun. Although he did come with a handgun like that, too. But, they're pretty similar. So that just shows you how close some of the things are in the show. Now, don't get me wrong, most of it is not close. They changed lots of things. But there are some things they got pretty much exact. And that was one thing there, his look in the beginning. I'll just go over articulation pretty quick, because this is actually more articulated than some of the newer Walking Dead figures, because he can actually sit down, I would say. He could possibly even ride Daryl's bike, maybe. I'll try that in a second. Most of the new Walking Dead figures cannot do this, cannot put their leg out like that. And the ankle moves around pretty decently. Arms, yeah. Spin there. He's pretty well articulated for one of these Walking Dead figures. Probably one of the more articulated ones out of all of them. And look at that. He kind of can ride the bike. He don't fit perfectly, but you can almost get him in a sitting pose. So that's pretty cool. I don't know why you'd want to do that. There's a black and white man riding down the road. And that brings us to the black and white bloody version of the comic Michonne. And I already viewed the colored version, which here it is right here. So they're both pretty cool. I kind of wish some of the colored versions came with a bloody version. Bloody, colored version. Blah, blah, blah. That'd be pretty cool, too. But then that'd be so many damn versions. That's too many versions. I'm going to have to buy them all. Holy shit. Let's see. Did they got that same... Yeah, that's weird. Both of them, they're like looking to the side. So I guess that wasn't a mistake on this one. For some reason, they made her looking to the side. This is weird to me. I think they should be looking straight ahead for a toy like this. I had the sword in this hand, but I think it's supposed to be in this hand. Something about the ways he's holding it just makes me think that's the arm that she's supposed to have the sword in, the katana. Some people are like, it's not a sword, it's a katana. I'm like, I think a katana is a sword. So, yeah. But he liked the colors I used on this. Despite it being black and white, you can see the different shades that, you know, just kind of like a black and white movie. They did this one pretty well. Like some of the TV black and white versions, like here's black and white TV Michonne. I don't think the black and white varies enough with the different colors of her clothes and everything. But this one I think they do a pretty good job on. Now, unlike Brick, she has blood splatter on her back a little bit. And maybe that's because she swings her blade around and just flings blood everywhere. And it's like... There's just blood all over her. So that's probably why she's got blood on her back. I don't know if they actually considered that and that's why they did it, but that's what I'm going to say. Now, if you've ever seen the original RoboCop movie, this bloody skirt kind of reminds me of that. And I will not explain why, because I don't feel like it. But, yeah, let's just say RoboCop saved her by shooting a guy in the dick that was standing behind her. So I guess I did explain it. And I think she comes with all the same accessories that the other version did. Not the Comic-Con version, because that came with a robe, her cloak, whatever that thing is. But this one comes with her katana. And you can see it's nice and bloody. And then it comes with a power drill. And that's one of the tools she uses against the governor when she, like, tortures him. Also comes with a hammer. A nice little hammer. It's not Tyrese's hammer, but she definitely knows how to use it. Makes really good use of it. Very painful use of it. Same with these pliers. Governor lost some fingernails with this. And the spoon. Probably the one that was the most disturbing was the spoon. And she kind of stuck that up the governor's ass, got it covered in shit, and then scooped his eyeball out with this shitty spoon. So that was pretty nasty. But that just shows you how much more graphic the comic was in that whole Governor Michonne thing than, you know, the TV show was. TV Michonne versus TV Governor, just kind of a slightly brutal fight. The eye gouge was the biggest thing with a piece of glass, but it's nothing compared to what they did to each other in the comics. I mean, He did some really messed up stuff to her, and she did even more messed up stuff to him. The articulation is better on her than on, you know, the TV show version of her. Like, she can actually put her legs a little bit forward, and they would actually go even more forward if it wasn't for her skirt hindering her a little bit. And I think she could probably also ride on that motorcycle. Let's see. Get on there. Eh, not as well as Rick, but pretty close. So, this Mr. Evilcheese, and I think this two-pack of comic versions of Bloody Rick Grimes, Bloody Black and White Rick Grimes, that's a lot of stuff to say. Bloody Black and White comic version of Officer Rick Grimes with Bloody Black and White version of Michonne. Glad she doesn't have a bunch of names, but I think it's pretty cool. I found it on Toys R Us. They have it on sale for $30, I think. $29.99, something like that, on Toys R Us online. And I think that's pretty much cheaper than anywhere else. So I'd say check it out if you're looking for this set, because that's why I got it. So, this Mr. Cheese, and I don't know what the hell I'm doing right now. But I'm just like kind of laying here, whatever. But I'm glad you watched my video, and thanks for watching, and this Mr. Cheese, and good. I think I'm saying things over and over. I'm having trouble tonight. I'm sorry. Goodbye! When there's no more room in hell, an army of Rick Grimes clones will do battle with an army of Michonne clones. And some sort of mutant retarded thing, and some kind of tiny little person, Michonne, and think, look at all them damn Michonnes. I only got 4 Ricks. I'll have some more soon, because they're coming out with some new ones. I guess what I'm trying to say is, I got a shitload of Michonnes. Shitload. Shitload. Shitload of Michonne. Shitmoat. I got a shitmoat. Don't try to attack me, or you'll get stuck in my shitmoat. Completely surrounds my castle. Or, wait, my asshole? I got a shitmoat that completely surrounds my asshole. You can't get in. There's shit all around. That's what I was trying to say. That's the point of this whole Rick versus Michonne's. Rick's versus Rick's Grimes's versus Michonne's. Okay, bye. Ba 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 ba.
Oh, damn it! Check out one of these other videos here by clicking on the picture or subscribing it. Yeah.